Welcome students, we are finding out the weathering of rocks and erosion methods. Okay, what are the natural agents that carry the weathering of rocks to faraway places? We are finding five things we are going to see in five headings. Already we saw three headings. One is the running water, we call it as the rivers or the streams. The next one we saw about the glaciers, right? And we saw about the third one, wind. Okay. The fourth one we are going to see about the sea current, that is sea waves and the current. Okay, so sea waves, all of you know the ocean current, sea waves, you have already studied, which is the major cause for the movement of the plates and weathering of rocks, everything that we have studied. As a world as a whole, you can see that how many places, parts is there, no? Only 1/4 of the, whole world space is there with the covering with the earth surface. The remaining part is there and the water, that is the ocean and sea. This current plays a major role in the formation of so many formations, which is of major importance. Okay, first we will be seeing. So the waves, tides and currents that forms the sea waves and current. So first we will see what is a sea, right? So a sea is an extensively developed, continuous body of salt water having inland extension and having a depth of less than 4 meters. But more than 4 meters, we call it as the ocean. So, this is the two things. The ocean is almost silent, right? It doesn't have so much of disturbances as the water. So, the sea, due to the tides, due to the waves and other things, it has caused so many changes, that is weathering of the rocks in many places. Okay, now we will see one by one. Again I tell, sea is an extensively developed continuous body of salt water. Already chemical reactions will be there and it has a depth less than 4 meters. Okay, so an ocean is a deep sea having a depth more than 4 kilometers, depth more than 4 kilometers, having an extensive area and gigantic underwater features. So the next one, profile of the sea floor. So the profile of the sea floor categorized into different zones and we will be seeing one by one, right? The first one, it is the continental shelf. This is the formation. The first one, it is a gentle sloping land part that remains partly submerged under sea water. You can see here, right? So this is the shore. This is the sea, it is going like this. This, it comes to the ocean. So this part we call it as the continental shelf. Here you can see very nicely. So it is the color difference. This is the earth part. These are the blue color. It represents the water. So this part, right? So where the depth is less than 4 meters. This is the continental shelf. It is very narrow, not even this. So just to the seashore and the part deep into the thing, that we call it as the continental shelf. The next one, it is the continental slope. After continental shelf, there will be a slope, right? A deep slope, or it may be a gentle slope. Mostly it will be a deep thing due to the erosions and other things. So this is called as the continental slope. So you can see here, right? This is continental slope. So here you can see it is a continental slope. So a continental slope is a slope starting from the farthest end of the continental shelf and continuous up to the sea floor. Okay, continuous till the sea floor. This we call it as the sea floor. So it continues till the sea floor. It we call it as the continental slope. Okay, so the next formation, it is the abyssal plains. Abyssal plains, you can see this is a plain. This is, we call it as the continental slope. This is the continental shelf. Where it reaches, this we call it as the abyssal plains. Here you can see, right? So, the after formation of the continental shelf, then continental shore, where it gives, this we call it as the abyssal plain, right? We can. So, each ocean is normally characterized with an abyssal flow and it is almost level. You can see here, right? It is almost level. You can see here, almost level. So, the next one we will see, it is the oceanic ridge. It is a continuous and extensively developed submarine mountain like structure that may be extending from one end to the other end of the ocean. You can see How it is formed means, due to the convection currents, this magma, that is the bottom part of the earth, which is very hot, it tries to move out, right? So it tries to move out, which is making the formation of the ridge. Okay, so here you can see mid-oceanic ridge. It will be the highest part. So here there will be a continental shelf will be there, then there will be a continental slope, then there will be a plain area of abyssal plain, after which this one, due to this movement of this one, there will be a ridge formation. And this ridge formation will be throughout this, that we call it as a mid-oceanic ridge. Okay, it is an oceanic ridge. It is a continuous and extensively developed submarine mountain-like structure that may be extending from one end to the other end of the ocean. Okay, the next one we call it for the continental rise. Okay, so the continental rise is a sediment underwater feature found between the continental slope and the abyssal plains. We find it between the continental slope and the abyssal plains. Here you can see, right? This is a continental shelf. This is a continental slope. This is abyssal plain. The part where it joins, we call it as the continental rise. It is mainly because of the sediment, that is the movement of the sediment, it is formed here. Okay. So day by day, due to the water current, it will go on, this will form as a plain. But the sediments that are this here, we call it as the continental rise. Okay. Here you can see, due to this formation of this continental slope, this is the abyssal plain. So the formation here, we call it as the continental rise. Okay. So the next one, it is a transform fault. What is a transform fault? It's a strike or the slip fault wherein the relative horizontal slip is accommodating the movement between two ocean ridges or other tectonic boundaries. These are connected on both ends to other faults. Okay, so you can see here, right, the transform fault, that is, there will be two planes like this. One plane will be here, the other plane will be here. One plane tries to move like this, the other plane tries to move like this. So there will be a ridge movement will be there, a shear movement will be there between the plates. So this will be forming this transform fault. There will be a fault there. You can see here, it is a transform fault. You can see here, this is a transform fault. Okay, it is mostly this transform fault, this ridge, all are mainly here, part where the earthquake, volcanoes, landslides, all are initiated in that. Okay, it is mainly due to the movement of the two plate, one against another. Okay, the next one we will see about is the seamount. Seamount is a single word and it is a large geological landform that rise from the ocean floor but does not reach to the water surface or sea level, and thus is not an island or islet or cliff rock. Right? Okay. So actually what is there? It is a large geological formation. It is formed like if this is ocean, that is the sea level, means this is a bedrock. Okay, bedrock. This is the sea level. It is formed like this. Okay, but it does not reaches to the top. If it is reaches to the top, it is called as the gyres. Right? So it is the like this. Okay. So what is this? So mainly what is the thing I want to tell you here? It is the day by day, this will be moving like this to the top. We call it as the gyres. Okay. And again, this will move and it will be formation of the volcanoes. Okay. The world's largest volcanoes are there under the sea only. It is there under the sea. Okay. You can see here. So this is the place we call it as the, that is the largest mass. It is like a mountain under the sea. We call it as a seamount. Okay. So you can see here. Okay. So there are so much of seamount there, you can see in the bedrocks. This we call it as the seamount. Okay. You can see here. But it will be not shore outside the land surface. The next one, it is the gyres. Gyres, you can see it is almost above the sea level. Right, it is a volcanic island, the erosion will take place and we call this as the gyre. This is the seamount. Okay, you can see this gyre will be mostly in the satellitic image, it is like this. So here you can see the formation of the Gayat. Okay. So the next one, it is the marine moat. Next we have to see sea moat and gayats. Okay, we have seen almost all the thing. So continental shelf is the horizontal place that is near the shore and the sea. After that there will be a ridge, we call it as the continental slope, continental shelf, continental slope. The part that is the plain part, we call it as the abyssal plain, right? Okay, the part between the continental slope and the abyssal plains, we call it as the continental rise. Okay, and the due to the movement of the magma towards outer surface, there will be a formation of mountain, we call it as the we call it as the ridge. Okay, and the fault will be there due to the movement of two plates towards the sliding and other things. There will be a gap that we call it as a fault, we call it as a transform fault. And there will be some mountains will be there, mountain formation will be there under the sea due to this water current, that is the current, sea current, sea that is sea waves movement. We call that as a sea mount if it is not shown outside the layer of the water. If it is coming outside, then we call it as the gayat. Okay. So the trenches are formed due to the movement of this fault and movement of the ridges. There will be very big trench means a big depression like things will be formed, that we call it as the trench. Okay. So the next we will be seeing about the marine water. What is marine water? Marine water, why we want to study the marine water is that it is a powerful geological agent for making the weathering rocks from moving from one place to the other place. Okay. So it is the most the powerful geological agent on the earth. The sea water acts as an agent of erosion. It transports and it deposits the particles to the various places. And all the geological work performed by the marine water is due to the regular and irregular disturbances such as waves and currents. I repeat again, this marine water is one of the most powerful geological agent for the earth to for erosion and weathering, that is for erosion, transportation and deposition of the weathering of the rocks from one place to another place. Mainly it is carried out by the form of waves and currents. Now we will see what is a wave. Okay, so waves are undulatory disturbances on the surface of the sea water due to strong winds, earthquake and attraction of sea water by the sun and moon and the other similar reasons. So it is the undulatory disturbances. It is not a regular disturbances. Here the waves are an undulatory disturbances. You can see all the waves are not the same. Okay. And it carries in the surface of the sea water. It may be due to a strong wind, due to an earthquake, underground earthquake. We call the sea waves as the even tsunamis will occur where the sea waves are very high. Earthquakes and the attraction of sea water by the sun and the moon. You know that in the case of the no moon, that is season, the sea water will rise to a heavy high level. Then the full moon season, right? So they will not tell, don't go to the sea water at the full moon or the no moon days. The sea water will have a differentiation. That is the due to the effect of the moon and the sun. So due to this, what is there now? There are two waves. That is, one is oscillatory waves, the next one is translatory waves. Oscillatory waves is the round waves, right? So oscillations, it goes in a round. Translatory waves almost moves in like this. Okay, due to this waves, this type of weathering will take place, this type of rocks will be formed. Now we will see about one by one. Okay, one is oscillatory waves. In these waves, each particle moves in a circular orbit. I told you now, here the waves will be moving in a circular orbit in the oscillatory waves. In the translatory waves, generally formed shallow depth of water commonly produced after the oscillatory waves breaks and run. So this oscillatory break will come, it will break and it will go back. In this, due to this one, this formation of translatory waves takes place. Okay, here you can see different, even more clearly. This is the oscillatory waves. The oscillatory waves are due to the oscillations, that is the circular movements, it will happen. And this translation, after this oscillatory breaks, right, due to this earth surface, it breaks now. Then the translation waves begin, and this will be due to the going and returning of this water to the rim. So it will be almost a, like this reason, not in a, that is a circular movement. The next one, it is a current. So we saw what is that? We saw waves. What is a wave? So why it is a wave is very important for a weathering reaction, because it is a strong wind that is more mainly due to the earthquake or the mainly due to the effect of sun and moon. So we have two types of wave. One is oscillatory wave and translatory wave. Which oscillatory waves is due to the more oscillation movement, that is the round movement, and while the translatory waves is after the oscillatory waves breaks, then the translatory waves goes and it will be due to the movement of the longitudinal direction, goes and returning back, right, it will form, right? You can see here this oscillation waves, this is the translatory waves. Next one is see about the current. So sea waves are different, sea currents are different. So this is a sea current in different parts of the world, right? So I have given it in a inverse diagram. So layers are strips of seawater that are actually pushed forward in any particular direction. So what is the main cause of sea currents? Results of dissipation of extra volume of water thrust on the shore by the advancing waves. That is mainly due to the strong winds, earth, and the effect of the sun and moon that cause the waves. These currents are due to the dissipation of extra volume of water thrust. Water thrust means it is force, right? Due to the water force on the shore, this current is formed. So what are the different types? Is the one by one, it is the littoral currents or longshore currents. Number two, it is the rip current or undertow current. Okay. So I told you this is the shore, near to the shore. The water force that is near, you can see this movement near to the shore. This we call it as the current. Okay. See here, it is littoral currents or longshore currents. The sea water bodies of considerable volume moving parallel to the shore, we call it as this littoral currents or the longshore currents. Okay, this is a beach, and this current will move almost in the longitudinal directions like this and like this. We call it as the longshore currents, or we call it as the littoral currents. Actually, longshore currents are caused by the waves which approach to the shore. Right, the waves that will be, if there is a shore, this is a beach, a shore like this, now there will be a waves like formation. Okay, this forms the longshore currents. Okay, what happens now? This moves the sand grains, silt, clay from the shore. Again, it will take it to the that is sea. Again, it will come to the beach. Right, but what is littoral drift is that. The movement of the sand along the beach because of this longshore current, we call it as the littoral drift. So we call it as a littoral current or a longshore current. It is the current that is moving parallel to the shore. The next one, it is the rip current. That is, it is undulatory and undertow current. That is, sea water bodies moving backwards to the sea. We call it as the sea rip current. Okay. So here you can see. Okay. So due to this movement of this long water, after some time it will again come back to the sea, right? That it forms the rip current. This is the rip current formation. You can see this is the formation, actual formation of the rip current. That is moving backwards to the sea after having reached and struck the seashore. They often move below the surface of the sea and reach varying distance up to the middle of the sea. They transport final materials and sediments out of the sea. Here you can see, right? Okay. You can see here. This is the longshore current moving like this. Okay. Due to this, it will come again. This is the movement of the rip current. You can see here. This is the sediment flow. This is the rip current moving here. You can see the rip current. You can see the rip current in a deeper canal. See here, it is moving back now. This carries all the sand, sediment, silt from here to the sea, right? Okay. So this is the two things. It is the longshore that is a longshore current and the rip current. You can remember this name alone. The next one we will see about the marine corrosion. So the marine erosion. The main erosion, the work of the erosion is performed and communicated in four ways. One is by the hydraulic action, abrasion, attrition, chemical reaction. Again, you see, wherever we go, the erosion, the mainly two things will come. One is abrasion, one is attrition. Abrasion is due to the striking of one particle to the other particles. It is colliding of one particles to the other particles. Attrition. First, you will see what is the hydraulic action. Okay. So, the hydraulic action, what happens? The process of erosion involves breaking, loosening and plucking out of the loose rocks from the original places by the strong forces created by the impact of sea waves and currents. Okay. The, again, I am repeating, this is the breaking of or loosening of the rock particles by the breaking, loosening and plucking. That is removing of the particles by strong forces. The strong forces, how it is formed? Due to the impact of sea waves and currents. Okay. The forceful current may carry the plucked out blocks of rocks away and it creates a rough and rugged surface. You can see. From here it will take and it will take and it has formed. So this will be creating a very rough surface. Okay, the next one, it is the abrasion reaction. Abrasion between the water and also the rock, we have already seen in the running water, right? The stream, running water, again we have seen. So the same thing, here the rubbing and polishing action of the sea water to the rocks, particularly in the seashore, right? It happens where the sea water comes and breaks in the rocks, we can see. Okay, so what happens means the sand and small fragments of rocks which are present in the seawater, again and again it is taken and broken away. Right, you can see this is one of the erosion that is mainly due to this abrasion particles. The water comes here, it will take all the soft particles. Here you can see the soft particles are carried away. The next one, it is the attrition. Attrition, I told you, mostly it is a collision, right? It is a collision where abrasion is the striking of one particles. Okay. So, if the two parts, that is the pebbles and the sands moving along the sea waves are further breaking down to smaller pieces due to the mutual collision. Mutual collision due to this water bodies carries these two things and it will collide mutually with one another, which again breaks down into small particles. That is, the pebbles are bigger than the sand particles. Due to this, breaking down, this type of rocks are formed. Okay. The next one, it is a chemical action. All of us know, sea water is already having some chemicals in it. It depends upon the type of sea. There it is present, everything it is there. So, what happens? The physical destructiveness of the waves is enhanced greatly by the chemical action of the sea water. That is, due to the physical action of the sea water, the if there is only a small weathering, but due to this chemical action of the seawater, the effect of erosion is impacted by a very greater extent. Okay. So, this is particularly seen where coast of composed of readily soluble rocks such as limestone and dolomites. So, the sedimentary rocks like limestone or the metamorphic like dolomites, when they are present there, this reaction will be much more. Okay, but particularly that the sea water, this erosions will be mostly in the shore of the sea. Okay, so the next one we'll see about the features of the marine erosion. So till now we saw what are marine erosion and we saw what are the four things. One is hydraulic action, the next one it is abrasion, third one we saw attrition, the fourth one we saw chemical action. Now we'll see the features of marine erosion. So, what are the main features that we are considering now? Okay, headlands, bays, wave cut cliffs, wave cut benches, shoreline, sea caves, sea arch, sea stack are the most of the features that is caused due to the soil erosion. Due to the soil erosion, that is the water, sea erosion, these are formed. Shoreline, headlands, bays, wave cut cliffs, wave cut bench, sea cave, sea arches, sea stack. We will see one by one. One is headlands, right? headlands and bays. Right? A lot of you know what is a bay. Bay of Bengal. Why we call it as a Bay of Bengal? It is the biggest bay in the world. Right? So this we call it as the bay. Right? Due to this water, it is coming, it is eroding the particles here. It is taking, it is eroding, eroding. This is called as a bay. So this we call it as the headlands. Okay. Now we will see. Headlands and bays, a uniform sloping shoreline composed of materials of unequal hardness and softer rocks get eroded so easily and quickly. So the particles where this is having very soft and very uneven rock surfaces, it will be washed away very quickly. And this is this we call it as the formation. That is here you can see the formation that we call it as the bay. So the bay is the formation like this mostly. This we call it as the headlands. Headlands are the base. Okay. So this actually, as this is eroded one by one, this becomes a very smooth surface. Okay. So the next one we see is the cliff. Then sea waves dash against a rocky shore and it is cut effectively. We call it as the cliff. You can see here. It is a cliff. It will be very steep due to the erosion of the soil particles. The next one, it is a formation of the clay, right? The cave, right? So due to this seawater, the cave can be formed. The next one, this is arches. This is one of the things where wherever you can see that it's so many wallpapers will be there. And this is the stacking, that is completely removing of this one from the sea, right? So next is this sea cliff we saw, wave cut bench and sea cave. And next we'll see about the features of the marine deposit. One is the water, there is shallow water deposit, deep water deposit. In shallow water deposit, we have wave cut or built terraces, beaches, spits, bars and tableau. Okay, so this we will see the features of marine deposit in the next class. So we will see till now what we have seen is that we have seen what is the erosion, that is due to the sea water, that is sea current, what is the effect we have seen. So we saw, first we saw what is the sea water, what is sea and what is the effect of this sea water on the thing, and we saw what is continental shelf, we saw what is continental slope, we saw what is abyssal plain, continental, that is this is the continental shelf, this is the continental slope, this is the continental rise, this is the plain surface, we call it as abyssal plain. Due to the movement, the ridge, that is the mountain formed with the biggest rock, we call it as the ridge. Due to this movement apart, we call that there will be a trench, that is a ditch formation, we call it as a fault. And there will be some mountains that is formed under the water, we call it as a sea mount. But the same sea mount, if it is seen outside the water, we call it as the gyre. Right? They may ask separately in 2 marks or 3 marks, individually you have to know about the definitions. Okay, the next we saw about the marine water and what is it affects mainly due to the waves and the currents, and we saw what is the 2 waves, oscillatory waves which moves in the circular motion and translatory waves which moves in the horizontal motion. And we saw what the currents, what are the currents, that is the littoral currents or the long wave current, that is the current across the sea beach, and the rip current, that is due to the movement of the water from the beach, it will be having a deep into the ocean, right? The movement of water in a circular way into the deep into the motion, that is the rip current. And the next one we saw what is the marine erosion, that is due to the 4 action. One is hydraulic action. Hydraulic action is movement of water, that is against the, you know, small rocks and the soft rocks. The next one, it is abrasion. Abrasion is due to the striking of the material, that is the water to the rocks, it forms a very smooth surface. And the next we saw what is the attrition, it is due to the collidal of the particles with one another. And we saw due to this process, what are all the features that is formed is the shoreline, headlands, shorelines, headlands, bays, wave cut cliff, wave cut bench, sea cave, sea arch and sea stack are the most formed features due to this marine erosion, right? So we have seen this. This is the bay, we are the largest bay, you can remember that is Bay of Bengal, which will have a very smooth and it is having a headland. Then the cliff will have a very short head, that is a top, right? It is a cave, all of you know. Then it is an arch like structure and it is stacked completely. The part that is the earth rock will be separated from the parent rock. Okay, so the next class we will see about the other part. topic of this marine, and also we will see about the groundwater hydrology. Okay, we will see in the next class.